Welcome to my Let's Play series of The Wolf Among Us. I'm Amethyst Lunatari, the RPG chick, and I'm clicking anywhere to begin. Now, at the time of this recording, they announced a sequel called The Wolf Among Us 2. So I'll be playing that one when it comes out. I basically wanted to get up to speed with this one. I have, like, over 100 games I want to play, but since they announced the upcoming sequel, I decided to push this towards the front. So, settings, because I like to show people these things. This takes place 20 years before the comic series, by the way. Controls we can't change, but I believe arrow keys work as well. I'll have to remember T for selectables. I don't know why T specifically. Shift for run. Cycling through inventory with the mouse wheel. Okay. I have the audio down like this, so you can hear me, but the subtitles are on anyway. Gameplay doesn't really have anything. I have selectables on. And graphics. This goes to high. It's basically high and low, so I have high. 1920 by 1080. Anti-aliasing. So. And the extras. This is locked. I don't know. I don't even know. Since Telltale. I mean, the old Telltale went out of business. I don't know if we can even see player choices anymore. That'd be interesting to see. Maybe just the old ones. I would assume maybe new ones don't show up. Telltale was acquired, I guess. I'm not sure. Bought by LCG Entertainment. They have most of their, not most, but a few of their licenses, such as The Wolf Among Us, the Fables license, and Batman. So, I can assume another Batman game. I mean, sure, I'll play it. Book of Fables. I'm guessing these are things that show up, yeah, during the episodes. So, and the numbers correspond. Sure, that's what it is. Achievements, I don't have yet. And so, playing. Starting episode 1. Wow. Big guy with an axe. So she's smoking a cigarette and fixing her makeup as he fights a guy with an axe. You gotta have priorities, you know? The standard Telltale kind of, not a warning, but for informational purposes. Once upon a time in New York City, there lived a community of fairy tale characters known as Fabletown. The fables who lived there arrived hundreds of years ago after they were exiled from their homelands. Through the use of a magic spell called Glamour, they have protected their secret community from the mundane world. Sheriff Bigby Wolf protects them from each other. Now, this is blind, meaning I have not played it. I've played up to the part where you talk to the first character. Not even going to give that away.
Date. Hottest ever in June. 103 now, and that humidity looks low, but remember, the hotter the air is, the more moisture it can hold. So 103 with 31% humidity is a lot more humid than, say, 73 with 31% humidity. And it is muggy out there.
So I actually never heard a weatherman, but I can remember explain it like that. But it makes sense. Oh, the scratch on the window. Guessing that was not from him. So I played up to not even through the first conversation, just to get a feel for the sound and make sure that the voices weren't booming over mine, kind of thing. Of course, I'm not going to talk over dialogue, it's just in case. I've always wanted to play this, and I've played a bunch of Telltale games. tenement building, South Bronx, sometime after midnight. I've played all the Walking Dead games. What else have I played?
Mr. Toad?
The Batman
Shit.
Games.
Bigby! Listen, mate, I know I don't look human. It's a problem, I get it. I just stepped out the apartment for just a second to see what kind of damage this drunk shit is doing. Just cut me a break, yeah? I'll get me glamour first thing in the morning. Cross my arm.
The glamour, yeah.
I need to kick up a fuss.
The glamour would make him look like human again. Looking at a 3-foot toad.
Looking at a 3-foot toad in a sweater.
Hmm.
That's a problem. If you can't afford to look human, you're going to the farm. It's as simple as that.
The farm.
You can't send me up to live with those animals. You know what I mean. Mm. Go see a witch. Get a glamour. Bigby, they're bleeding me dry, mate. The quality of the spout goes down, but the rates keep climbing up. Do you have any idea how much it costs to have an entire family in glamour?
I don't make the rules.
I don't make the rules. Sorry. I can't give you a free pass on this, Toad. My hands are tied.
Right.
There's too much at stake.
Mr. Toad will remember that.
At great cost, it's worth it. You don't want me catching you out of glamour again.
Whoops.
Fucking hell. See? This is what I called you about, Sheriff. You're just gonna stand there? Do something, Bigby. Before he completely tears up the place.
So what have I walked into? Oop, nope, silence. That was a quick one.
Thanks for that, Bigby. You're a real gentleman.
I was listening to you ramble.
This is the last straw, Bigby. He has to go.
Is a fight up there? Why is he so pissed?
So what set him off? Who knows why it was this time? Man's got a hair trigger. I avoid him as much as possible.
Just smashing things?
When did he start drinking? Not sure he ever stopped.
Fuck you!
I didn't know anyone else was up there.
Oh? I doubt that was his voice. New Book of Fables entry unlocked. Okay, cool.
Furry prick gobshite. Tell me how to spend my money.
Hey, I heard
Dad,
that.
Dad, the lights are shaking again.
What did I say? You want a big bad wolf to take you away?
Aw.
No.
Aw.
Then get the fuck back inside.
I don't talk to a little kitty like that. It's a tiny little toad. Tiny little toady.
You're gonna know who I fucking am, you hear me? Hey, look at me!
Stop, okay? You're drunk!
Matchbook.
Let go!
Look at the matchbook on the floor and use the hand icon to pick it up. Well, I've already done so.
Take a look. Take a good look. Know who I am now? Hey, look at me!
Get off of me!
Ah! Maybe we should stop this. Knock? Yeah, let's knock. I think I should have busted in. That was not allowed. That's a proper knock. There you go. I didn't select open.
God damn you!
Oh!
Whoa, hey!
You've got something on your face.
Fuck are you talking about, you stupid cunt?
Oh, now you know.
I'll fucking kill you!
What's going
you
on here?
Fucker. All right, what's going on?
Oh, ow.
What are you gonna fucking do, huh? Get the fuck out of the way before you get the axe again.
This is your last warning.
Woody, this is your last warning.
Woody, huh?
If you keep on like this, I won't have any choice but to put you down. Put me down?
Just gonna remember that.
What a shit fucking memory, Wolf. That's not how it went last time.
This isn't last time.
What was last time like? Ow.
You gotta calm down.
Right into the sink. There you go. Uh-oh. You're right into the quick time events. Oh, I was waiting for that.
For punishment?
Fuck you.
Oh. Oh! I didn't make that last one? Ouch. Ow. Let me do something. Click! Yeah! Take those photos. Uh-oh. We get right into it. Out the window. He's got another weapon. Oh, I forgot this. I could use the other end, but no, I'm a good Bigby.
You should probably get out of here.
Look, I'm not leaving until I get what's mine.
You're not getting shit, bitch.
What's that you said?
I'll fucking put you in the ground.
Shut up.
Shut up. Oh, fucking shit. You bogged my jaw, you bastard.
Yep, I bogged my jaw.
Still you talk.
Fuck you.
Shit.
What happened?
What the hell is going on? What happened?
A little misunderstanding that turned into a real shit show. Don't worry, you saw the best bits.
There's more where that came from, girlie. Knock it off!
Look, this is just the start of a shitty night for me. I just need the money he owes me, then I can go.
You alright?
Are you alright?
I'm hunky-dory. Thanks for asking.
Where's this money? Why was he hitting you?
Why was he hitting you?
Maybe you should ask him that.
I will, but I asked you first.
She doesn't want to say,
He asked me if I recognized him, knew who he was. I said I didn't. He started beating on me. Then you showed up, started beating on him. That about cover it, hon?
I'm the Woodsman, you whore.
The Woodsman?
I saved Little Red Riding Hood from this monster. I cut this fucker open.
Really?
Filled his belly full of stones.
Ow.
And threw him in the fucking river. That's who the fuck I am, you stupid bitch.
Hey.
Hey, what did I say about that word?
Come on.
Ooh. Ouch. We know how to make an exit, that's for sure. Now you're out
hey,
in the open.
Toad.
My car.
Yeah. Give me a second.
Oh, no, by all means. Take your time. Make yourself comfortable.
Get off the street.
Can I get you anything? Pillow, perhaps?
Toad, you need to get off the street. You don't have your glamour.
Apologies for smashing your car, Toad. I'm gutted for you, mate. It's a real shame. But that's not you, is it? Gotta play the old man role.
Some things are more important than your car.
Well, at least you're not fucking dead.
Uh-oh. Oh, no. Is that a Terminator poster? I am already tired of fighting this guy. Oh my god, really? I don't know if I can.
I know you're fucking in there. Come on out, you fucking dog.
I can't make this. I can't.
I'll put you out of your misery.
Come on.
You fucking mongrel. You ignorant fuck.
Okay, I'm killing my freaking hand here. Oh! New entry. In the dark future of 1996. So I guess these people are immortal, basically? Or he's dead. I don't know. Oh, she's looking for his money. What are you doing?
What are you doing?
I'm just getting what he owes me. You all right back there? I mean, your eyes and the teeth. You're not really supposed to do that, are you?
Not if I can avoid it.
Great.
The guy's got an axe in his brain. He's not feeling that.
It's more from me. He'll be fine.
I'll kill you, you fucking bitch.
Let me help you.
Ooh. Alright, snuff.
He's had enough.
He's a fable. Son of a bitch can take plenty.
How do you kill these people? If they're even... Some of them can't be called people, right? Beings? Oh my god. Ow. Mongoose? Really? Oh, like cobra. Mongoose instead of cobra. It wasn't Terminator, it was a cobra.
Just come on.
Reference. Do I have a light? Oh! I couldn't decide. She did it. I might want the matchbook for something.
Who do you work for, really?
These lips are sealed. Sorry.
Oh. Maybe if I'd given her the matchbook. Yeah, why? Look
hey,
at that. Why?
You like my ribbon?
Why are they sealed? I'm trying to help you.
If you don't answer my questions, I can't help you.
I'm answering them the best that I can.
By not answering them?
I feel like we've met before.
We probably have. We all sort of knew each other at one point or another. But things change, I guess.
She knew the Woodsman, too. But that's not, Red Riding Hood, is it? Totally. Dragon Wing at Madison Square Garden.
We don't have to make any more of a thing out of it than it already is.
He hit you.
He hit you. He needs to pay for that.
He's got nothing to give, Sheriff. I checked. Besides, I just swung an axe into the guy's head. I'd say we're even.
He's not gonna...
I should be arresting you.
He's not gonna take it that way.
I'm not gonna be doing this for much longer. So, now's your chance.
Huh.
How much was it he owed you?
100.
I'm guessing it'd be bad for you to show up empty-handed.
I'll be fine.
Let's give her some money. Do I have money? I guess not.
Let's see, I've got, it's 20, 40, 7, 8, 58. It's all I got. It'll help, right? Take it.
It's okay. I'll be fine. You've done enough, really.
Just take the money, okay?
You got me out of a bad situation back there. Thanks.
I'm still gonna need a statement.
You give us some info.
I have to go drop off what I have.
Meet me back at my office, then.
It's a little late for an office visit, Sheriff. I'll swing by your apartment.
How do you know where I am?
You live in the smallest apartment in the Woodlands. Everyone knows that.
Good to know.
You should get cleaned up. You look like shit.
Thanks.
And I don't use that term lightly.
Ah.
Some of these look pretty bad.
Tell me what you really think.
Wow. Tell me what you really think.
Hey. I need to tell you something.
Okay.
What is it?
You're not as bad as everyone says you are. I'll see you around, Wolf.
He just likes to watch you leave, huh? Well, I didn't light her cigarette, but at least I gave her, what, $58? Telltale Games presents Telltale Story by Pierre Charette and Ryan Kaufman. Okay, I'm not gonna read all this. Now, a while, not long after Telltale itself closed its doors, they started taking stuff off of Steam and GOG. So I ended up downloading what I had, just in case. Because some people said stuff was missing out of what they had already bought. And I had bought this and a few other Telltale games. And never played them. Episode 1, Faith. And that would stink to buy a game, never play it, and then disappears. Bullfinch Street. The Woodland Luxury Apartments. And I actually went on... It's Fabletown, late. I actually went on eBay. There was some stuff that was delisted that I never got to play. I ended up going on... Was it the eBay or Amazon shops? I got Back to the Future of the Game and the Tales of Monkey Island. I will play them someday. But when games disappear, I don't like that. We want to preserve that. So they might be relisted, you know, with this LCG Entertainment might relist some of this stuff, but it probably depends if they have the license, so I don't know if they'll have the license to Tales from Monkey Island or Back to the Future, so who knows, but I have them on CD-ROM, DVD-ROM. It's gotta be DVD-ROM. So it should all be good. Because that's what I started playing. I started, back from the beginning. Okay, go that way. I can actually go this way. Is there anything here, though? Glass slippers, shoes. So, I'm glad at least back then they had physical releases.
Yeah, I guess Shoes by Cinderella would have been too obvious.
I am the Eggman Diner. Can't walk into the street. The gate. The Woodland Luxury Apartments. Look at the plaque.
Luxury apartments? Wish they wouldn't advertise that.
He doesn't want people to know he lives in a luxury apartment. Oh, it would look like we could... Wait. We can't. Once we get in this screen... Yeah, okay, never mind. I wanted to look at that diner. I guess at some later time. We'll be able to. Yeah. Bill Willingham. I had a few issues of the comic, believe it or not. It was interesting. It wasn't my favorite or anything like that.
Snow can sometimes be a disciplinarian.
Snow? Snow White? Who goes there? I saw that. Come on out.
Come on out.
All right.
Beauty.
Oh, Beauty. Hello, isn't Beauty and the Beast. So much for the grass.
I wasn't expecting anyone. I know this looks a little odd, but there's an explanation.
Why did you hide?
Why'd you hide when I walked up?
Well, I didn't know who it was. You can't be too careful these days.
No, you can't.
Damn it, I'm late.
For a very important date?
Please, Bigby. Promise me you won't tell Beast you saw me. He worries too much as it is, and it would just make my life a lot easier. Just, please.
What's the Beast side of this? I promise?
Promise me?
Sure.
You promise?
I promise.
Thank you, Bigby. I'll explain it all to you later. I will, but I have to go.
I wonder what it's all about. Oh, I gotta check that.
Thank you for trusting me. Really, I appreciate it, Bigby.
I can tell. I gotta check those entries. Might tell us something about what's going on with her and Beast and what the current status is and stuff. Book of Fables. Big B Wolf, Fabletown Sheriff, the renowned Big Bad Wolf. He's known for tormenting pigs and girls in red hoods, but is trying to put those dark days behind him, really. Big B now acts as Fabletown Sheriff and remains in his human form, mostly. However, due to his rough past, the citizens of Fabletown are slow to trust him. Big B is determined to... Oh, wow. Okay, it goes line by line. To show that he's truly changed, but some instincts are just too hard to control. The Woodsman, fallen hero. The Woodsman is one of the few men who went toe-to-toe with Big Me in his Black Forest days and lived to tell the tale. In an attempt to save Little Red Riding Hood, he split the Great Wolf's belly open with his axe, filled him full of rocks, and threw the beast into a river. To his dismay, his popularity has faded, even his name is forgotten, and he is only known as the Woodsman. Does he know his name? Beauty, caring wife, really. Beauty and her husband Beast once lived in an enchanted castle, but they were forced to flee the homelands in the Exodus, leaving all of their wealth behind. Now they live in a modest studio in Fabletown, New York, though times are hard with Beast working multiple jobs to pay the bills. Wow. I tend to lose it. Yeah, the couple have the longest-lasting relationship of all the fables. But where is she sneaking off to? She doesn't want him to know. Mr. Toad. Slumlord. The superintendent for a defunct tenement on the edge of... Fabletown proper. Because he's a 3.5-foot talking amphibian, Toad is required by Fabletown law to keep his family and himself magically glamored to appear human. The problem is Toad isn't too concerned with what the law is and has to be reminded often. So we've seen. Fabletown, home of the fables. Fabletown is a community located on Bullfinch Street in Manhattan's Upper West Side. To regular people, or Mundies, it appears to be an ordinary New York neighborhood, but is really the home of fables from many worlds, and within the business office at the Woodlands lies a massive cavern, a vast library, and hundreds of magical items of immense power. All non-human fables live upstate on the farm, an extension of Fabletown. Manhattan's Upper West Side. Well, I hope I get to visit that and check that out soon. The Farm. Fabletown Annex. The farm is home to fables who cannot pass as human, giants, goblins, animals, etc. It is located in upstate New York, far enough away from the Mundies to avoid detection. Some of its residents resent their confinement to the farm despite its size and comforts. To them, the farm is a prison. They would be allowed to leave the farm if they could purchase a glamour, but many don't have the money for something so expensive, though some, like Colin, sneak out into the city anyway. Colin? Is that the... Oh, he's just Mr. Toad. He didn't sneak out. He's a superintendent. He works there, so I'm not sure who Colin is. Glamorous. Disguise spell. Glamours are spells that allow the user to change their appearance. They are expensive, but can be purchased by non-human fables in order to pass for human among the Mundies. Cheap glamours can be found in the seedier parts of Fabletown, but they are often unreliable and prone to sudden failure. That could be awkward. You know, you're talking to somebody and all of a sudden you see a toad in front of you. Achievements? This isn't going to give me spoilers, is it? Oh, it doesn't show what the other... Oh, it does there. Wait. Achievements. Complete chapter 1 of episode 1. Wait. Is that what it is? Oh. Okay. Not much of an achievement, really. Suit of armor. Touch it? Look at it first.
Flycatcher needs to dust this guy.
That was bang it. Just look at him. Not gonna talk to him yet. Okay. Yeah, it's pretty typical of some times when you look at things in Telltale games, he actually just looks at him. Or it, or whatever.
Been a while since I got any mail.
Should we see if we have any?
Seventh day in a row.
Are we 205? Now there's something over here. Woodland Directory. Jack Horner? Hold on. Wimble F Catcher. Fly Catcher. He mentioned Fly Catcher. Mr. and Mrs. Beast, B. Blue, J. Horner, B. Blackbeard, King Cole, S. White, Storage. I can kind of read it, barely. The rest say private. S. White, though. Snow White. Oh, there's some down there. Bigby's name tag.
Damn thing fell off again.
Oh, get it. I can't get it.
Damn thing fell off again.
Oh, I can use name tag with. Okay, I don't have to pick it up and then put it.
How much longer is this gonna go on?
We need something better to, you know, attach it with.
You'd think the sheriff would get a permanent listing.
So we're 204, not 205. So T is interactables. Pressing T. Don't seem to be doing anything different. I mean, I think it would highlight this. Maybe things that aren't already highlighted. So it's too late to use it. T. Doesn't seem to be working. Tried tab as well. Alright, let's wake him up.
Hey, You awake?
If we can. He's obviously not awake. Grimble.
Probably for the best.
Is he playing with suction cup darts? Or somebody using that on him? Going up?